Welcome to Rajendra Tandon videos. We take up the arrival of Krishna in the Kaurava court at Hastinapur to find out a common ground for settlement of the dispute between the Kauravas and the Pandavas. The arrival of Krishna has been described beautifully in the Mahabharata. He had decided not to accept Duryodhan's reception and stay with him. Rather, he went and stayed with Vidur. He arrived at the court holding hands with Vidur and Satyaki. His presence illuminated the place like the sun and the stars in the sky. He was preceded by Karna and Duryodhan and followed by Kritvarma and other warriors. Bhishma, Drona and all the other kings and princes present in the court stood up to welcome Krishna. A golden throne had been kept ready for him to sit upon. Krishna responded to the welcome gestures of the king Dhritarashtra as well as of the elders like Bhishma, Dronacharya, Kripacharya and others. All the kings present there bowed to him. The angry Karna and Duryodhan sat on a seat next to Krishna, as if they wanted to overawe him. Everybody's eyes were concentrated on Krishna. Bhagavan Janardana, they drank in his sight as if they were drinking Amrita. Krishna glowed like the mustard flower. He had put on yellow robes. He shone like a blue diamond placed on a golden pad. His teeth were shining. He looked handsome, lovely, glorious. His voice sounded like a dundhubi, like the roar of a cloud in the summer sky. He looked at Dhritarashtra and said, Bharata Nandan, O descendant of Bharata, I have come to you to establish peace without anybody being hurt on either of the sides. I do not want to give any other message except of peace. All of you are aware of my intentions. Today, your family, O King Dhritarashtra, is the supreme in the entire Bharatvarsha. All other kings bow before you. Certain qualities are found in greater abundance in the Kauravas and the Pandavas than in any other king These are kripa, obliging others, anukampa, compassion, karuna, taking mercy, alleviating others' suffering, and the absence of shrinsata, of cruelty. In spite of that, if your family performs or acts wrongly, that would not be desirable. If openly or stealthily your progeny wants to cheat the Pandavas, that would not be correct, and you have to apply a brake over such an activity. In the past, O Kuru Nandan, Duryodhan and other kings supporting him and his friends, ignoring their demand of dharma and their karma and their financial status, have acted against the Pandavas in a cruel fashion. They have treated their closest relations with a total lack of civility. Their greed has overpowered their judgment. They have broken the boundaries of dharma. And, O King, you are aware of all this. I do not have to repeat what has been done to the Pandavas. If tomorrow a war takes place between the two sides, it would destroy the entire world. In my view, it is not impossible to settle for peace if both sides agree. To arrive at a settlement, you have to make an effort, I have to make an effort, and if both of us make an effort, we would succeed. I'm sure of that, said Krishna. You keep your sons under control, and I shall see that the Pandavas' path is the correct one. Your sons and their friends and their followers should obey you. If controlling them, you opt for peace and a negotiated settlement, it is towards your benefit. An enmity with the Pandavas, cheating them by committing fraud, cannot bear desirable results. Keeping this in mind, I ask you to come for a settlement. If you do so, O King, the Pandavas, who too are descendants of the King Bharata, would help you, would cooperate with you. Let me tell you, Maharaj Bharata Shrestha, that both the sides are equally strong. On your side is Bhishma, Drona, Kripacharya, Karna, Ashwatthama, Somadatta, Jayadratha. And on the other side, the five Pandavas have supporters in Satyaki, Virat, Drupad. How can the two sides match each other? They are both strong. If both of you unite, come together in a settlement, the entire world would bow to you. You would be the king of the universe, like the sun god. All the other kings who control smaller territories would obey you, would settle with you, to be obedient, and would live and rule under your overall suzerainty. Your life would be full of happiness if you listen to me and settle with the Pandavas equitably. O Maharaja, there is nothing but destruction if a war starts. In the destruction of the two sides, which dharma are you following? If the Pandavas are killed in the battle, if your brave sons are also killed, how would you be happy? How would you lead the rest of your life in peace? The results of a war are destruction. To me it seems that this war would destroy the Kauravas as well as the Pandavas. Nobody would survive. All the brave people who have assembled to fight on either side would be killed one by one. Your Majesty, please try that instead of getting killed, all the princes, all the kings assembled here depart happily. You are growing old, sir. Please give the same love to the Pandavas as you did years ago. Settle for peace. They lost their father when they were young. You have reared them up. Give them the same justice which you want to deliver to your progeny. If you act with enmity, dharma as well as earth on your side would be destroyed. Continuing, Krishna said, Rajan, the Pandavas have sent you this message with humility. They have said, O Father, we have suffered so much. We followed your orders for the exile. We could have said no. 12 years we spent in jungles, 1 year incognito. You are our elder, you are our elder uncle. Whatever promises we have made, we shall follow. That is why we suffered so much. We wanted to keep our word. We stood by that. We now request you to stand by your word, by your promises that when we come back, our kingdom of Indraprastha would be returned to us. We have suffered enough. Uncle, now we should be allowed to live in peace and enjoy our kingdom, which has been taken away by fraud, by Duryodhana. Protect us. You are knowledgeable of dharma and of earth. You should treat us like a father. You should treat us like a mother, because you have been both to us. Treat us with love, affection. Play with us fairly and give us justice. We do not ask for anything more. Please follow the path of dharma. We shall also follow the path of dharma. we shall always keep walking on the correct path, the path of our duty. If in your lifetime some wrong is done to us, it's condemnable, it is not desirable. If in the presence of your courtiers you deny us justice and they do not oppose it, they are also violating dharma and their duty towards fairness. A court in which adharma enters and in which the courtiers do not oppose and throw it out, pluck it out like a thorn, destroys itself. A stream uproots the trees growing on the embankment. Similarly, violation of dharma would destroy these kings and the courtiers who are sitting in this assembly. Bharata Shrestha, we Pandavas are always looking towards dharma. That is why we are silent. We request you to return our kingdom. Our insistence is based on truth, dharma and justice. Please save all the Kshatriyas who would be destroyed in the war if it takes place. Krishna, after giving the message from the Pandavas, continued, Bharata Shrestha, be at peace. Don't yield to anger. Don't yield to greed. Hand over the Pandava share of the kingdom and enjoy the rest of your kingdom with your sons who are all brave warriors. Your son's treatment of the Pandavas is not unknown to you. Lakshagriha was constructed and an effort was made to burn them alive. They were thrown out of the kingdom. They came back to you. Yudhishthira has never disobeyed to you. Shakuni managed to defeat him in the game of dice and fraudulently threw them out of the kingdom. Draupadi was brought to the court and insulted, humiliated. Her sari was unwound. Yudhishthira did not lose his sense of dharma and justice. O mighty king, I am only trying to do good to both the sides, for yourself, for your sake, for the sake of your family, and for the sake of your praja. Do not give up dharma, earth, and happiness. At the moment, you are treating destruction as a source of happiness. You want kingdom and wealth to make you happy. You are in the wrong, Maharaja. You are impelled by the greed of your sons. You want them alone to be happy. Please control yourself and your emotions. The sons of Kunti, who can destroy any enemy, are ready to be at your service, but also they are ready for a fight. Now it is for you to decide whether you want fight or you want peace in the kingdom. You decide which is better for you and follow that path. Krishna closed his request with these words. We close here today. We meet you again with another story from Mahabharata.